Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. Hello and welcome to the 27th episode of the Treatise of Rights series with me, your host, Ali Jasim. Today we will discuss the right of the younger one. Regarding this, Imam Al-Sajjad, Zain al-Abidin, Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, has said, "And the right of him who is younger than you is that you have compassion on him, train and educate him, pardon him, and cover up his faults, be gentle with him and help him. Cover up the guilt of his juvenility, because this will make him repent. Treat him with patience and stop quarreling with him. This will lead him to more sensible conduct." When Islam says respect the other, it didn't say respect elders only or respect this group only. It said respect the other, which means respect everyone regardless of their age, gender, nationality, religion, etc. People of older age should treat children in a manner that allow them to be more confident. Imam Sajjad alayhi salam recommends us to treat younger people with kindness, educate them, pardon them, and cover up their faults. We should be patient with them and help them with their affairs. Undoubtedly, being egocentric is one of the foundations of the development of children's personality. If used properly and directed well, it can lead to their prosperity. A proper way to respond to this egocentrism is to respect the children and attend to their personality. Any child whose egocentrism is not properly recognized in the family will feel humiliated. He will have a feeling of having failed in life. He will be depressed. Such children are prone to various deviations and faults. That is why Imam Sajjad alayhi salam instructs us to overlook their mistakes. The noble Prophet of God Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, his pure progeny, has said the following regarding child rearing. Respect your children and improve your behavior. Imam Sajjad has stressed training and educating children as one of the major duties of parents, and writes that children have incumbents upon their parents. The practices and the lives of the Immaculate Imams alayhim salam are good examples of this. In today's world, children are considered to be very important. Full attention is given by societies and governments to their upbringing and respecting their personality in the family and the society. In spite of this, people today do not pay as much attention to children's instruction as the leader of the Muslims did. Although sometimes statesmen in industrialized countries visit orphanages and kindergartens, sometimes hugging children for photo ops and media publicity, demonstrating their love and respect for children, to date no individual can be compared with the Prophet of Islam. With the utmost simplicity and kindness, he passed through the alleys and streets, expressing his love and kindness towards children and hugging them. The Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, had a special love for children, whether they were his own or children of others. It has been written about him, kindness towards children was one of the special practices of the Prophet. When raising children, it's very important to make them feel like they're important, like their opinion matters. This is because that so they feel that they are not ignored and they are very important. Imam Ali alayhi salam asked his children intellectual questions in the presence of others, and in some cases he would let his children answer the questions of others. Once Imam Ali Amir al-Mumin alayhi salam asked his children Imam al-Hasan and Imam al-Husayn some questions, the latter responded wisely and briefly. Then Imam Ali turned to someone known as Harith Awar, who was present in the gathering, and said, "Teach these wise words to your children to improve their reasoning and thinking abilities." Thus, Imam Ali expressed his respect for his children in the best possible way and contributed to the creation of the greatest personality and independence in them. One of the most basic factors in the development of a child's personality is sociability and proper treatment. Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, his pure progeny, clearly advised his followers concerning this. He told them, "Respect your children and treat them good, with good manners and in an acceptable way." Time for a quick short break. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Therefore, those who want to have children with a strong personality must guide them in good training and avoid treating them improperly, as an improper practice cannot lead to the upbringing of worthy children who have a strong personality. Fulfillment of promises towards children is extremely important. That is because it contributes to the development of their self-confidence and affects their personality. The true leaders of Islam have given much advice about the fulfillment of promises to children. Some examples are as follows. Imam Ali, the commander of the faithful, peace and blessing be upon him, said, "It is not appropriate to tell lies, whether seriously or jokingly. It is not appropriate to make a promise to one's children and fail to fulfill it." Imam Ali also said, the Prophet said, "If any of you makes a promise to his child, he must fulfill it." Numerous sayings have been counted in Shia sources from the Shia Imams about the necessity of parents fulfilling their promises. Imam Hassan alayhi salam gathered his children and his brother's children once and told them, "You are all children today, but will soon be great men in the future, so acquire knowledge. Whoever of you does not have a good memory, he should write down with what his teachers say and keep the notes at home for later review." We see that Imam Hassan alayhi salam uses the children's egotism to encourage them to study to become great men in the future. He does not resort to punishment or threatening. Rather, he shows them that their studies today will pave the way for their progress tomorrow. What is done by Imam Al-Hasan alayhi salam is the best known method of educational guidance today. Thus, if a family succeeds in encouraging their children to study by raising hopes for their future progress in them, that family can direct them to eagerly pursue knowledge. There is no need to resort to threatening them or using force and punishment. One of the most fundamental conditions for the proper development of our children today is freedom. The same holds true for adults. There is no hope for progress in an environment full of oppression. It is the calm atmosphere of freedom that fosters the flourishing of talents. That is why Muslim teachers do not resort to the use of force as much as possible. The Prophet of Islam, peace be upon him, who was the teacher of humanity, was very kind. Ibn Mas'ud narrated that once when a man went to see the Prophet, he was afraid to talk. The Prophet said, "Do not be afraid, I am not a king." The noble Prophet said, "Whoever has a child should behave like a child with him." Imam Ali said, "Whoever has a child should play with him." The noble Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, also said, "May God's mercy be upon a servant of God who helps his child in righteousness through goodness to him and friendliness towards him, and through educating and training him." Whenever the noble Prophet of God returned from a journey and met the children on the way home, he stopped in respect for the children. He then asked smaller children to come forward. He picked them up and hugged them. He put some of them on his shoulders. He instructed his companions to hug children and let them ride on their shoulders. He said, "Children get really happy this way." The children never forget these moments. Whenever they got together, they probably talked about how the Prophet of God hugged them and gave them a ride on his back, or that he ordered his companions to give them rides on their backs. When a child commits a mistake, before taking action, we must put in mind that child's intention and his reasoning behind his actions. Imam Sajjad alayhi salam instructs us to pardon the faults of children and overlook their mistakes. Overlooking and pardoning some of their faults of children is one of the major moral issues that should be used in the education of children. It is sometimes more effective to overlook other people's mistakes and act as if you know nothing about them. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam said, "Goodness of companionship and living together is a full measure, two-thirds of which is possessing understanding and one-third of it overlooking the shortcomings of others." The Prophet of Islam Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, has also stressed the importance of overlooking other people's mistakes, as we can read in the following narration. Half of the nature of the believer is overlooking mistakes. Of course, there are two forms of overlooking. One form is recommendable, while the other form is not desirable. The form of overlooking of other people's mistakes that is recommended by the leaders of Islam is based on the intellect and is meant to make improvements. It is done with good intentions. Teachers can get good results from overlooking if they do it at the time and in the proper place. As an example, stealing money from the parents is sometimes done by children all over the world. The instinctive desire to own develops in children sooner or later. Then they start to consider everything their own property. They may take other kids' toys or pick some money up from their father's pocket. In these conditions, it is best for the father to say, "Some money has been taken from my wallet." Then the mother should say, "Is there anyone in this house who might do such a thing?" "No, of course not." Then the father should apologize and say, "I am sorry. It must have fallen out of my pocket, or maybe I did not get the right change back when I was shopping. Then the child will think over what he has done and say to himself how good it is that no one found out about it. Then he will decide not to do it again since this will threaten his honor. As stressed by Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, this is one of the situations in which overlooking a child's mistake is recommendable and will lead to an improvement in his behavior. With this, we conclude this episode. Stay tuned for another episode on the Treatise of Rights. Thank you all for watching, and may Allah hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.